together as one. So when the population is one and when a Sanskriti is established, it leads to a good economy. How? The biggest problem that Bharat is facing now is the economic disparity in terms of GDP in different states, which again arises because of the different geography and culture of each state. So when we bridge the gap between these two, that even the most impossible and difficult policies like one nation, one tax, demonetization, bringing down the black money becomes more easy to exercise. And hence, when a nation is geographically connected, the population becomes one. When the population becomes one, a Sanskriti is established. With a good Sanskriti, we have a common code of conduct. With a common code of conduct, it becomes easier for the government to govern, leading to an equal empowerment of all the states, thereby leading to the equal empowerment of the nation. When this happens, despite staying in Bharat, nobody will have an anti-Indian thought. You know, no tukde tukde gangs. And so, you might ask me whether is this a possible idea in today's world, and I would very proudly say yes. And the best example that I can give to you is this very program, the National Youth Parliament Festival. Just like in the past, how Adi Shankaracharya ji started from the south and connected the entire nation, here we are from different nooks and corners of the country, from different cultural backgrounds, and yet sitting together as the new voices of India for a strong and a united Bharat. My dear brothers and sisters, the world is looking at Bharat like it had never looked at us before. Do you know why? Kyunki ye naya India hai. Ye kahi ghusega bhi aur marega bhi. Wherever we go, may it be in any fields, economy, technology, terrorism, wherever we go, India will strike so hard that the world will not forget us anytime soon. So I call upon all of you to connect Bharat, to be a part of a stronger and a united Bharat. And